Hey guys, it's Jill. Welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, welcome. So, today we are going to be starting 75 hard. Now, how I'm going to update you guys on this channel is I'm going to be doing weekly updates, and then I'm also going to be doing monthly updates. So, 75 hard, real quick breakdown, is for 75 days straight. You have no cheat meals, no alcohol. That kind of goes into one. Drink a gallon of water a day. Drink a gallon of water a day. Did I say that right, or did I just say it really fast? You have to do two workouts. One has to be outside, okay? That's very important. They can both be outside, or one can be inside, but one has to be outside. Weather conditions do not apply in this challenge. Raining, I don't care. Get your butt outside and do a workout. Number four, take a progress picture daily. Why daily? I don't know. Why not weekly? Probably just to get you in the habit of doing it. Number five is to read 10 pages of nonfiction every single day. How I am personally doing this is I am also adding two more things into the bunch, because there's a lot of books that I've been putting off that I wanted to read, and a lot of them are on audiobooks. So with that being said, I also added in do at least 10 minutes of doing, like, listening to an audiobook, like a self-help kind of entrepreneurial type self-help book, for 10 minutes a day. Basically just listen to, that's what I'm gonna listen to, an audiobook. I'm not gonna listen to like a romance novel on Audible. I'm just not, right? And then I also have to make and drink a green smoothie every single day to just kind of help me get more greens in, and that's a really great way to do it. So yeah, those are my personal goals. We are going to kill it. Let's get started with day number one and see where it takes us. So let's go ahead and get started.
If no one invests in you, invest in yourself. If no one believes in you, believe in yourself. Even if you don't see the results right away, keep showing up until you do see the results. Even if you don't see the results for a very, very long time, keep showing up. What if the results don't come? They're not going to come if you quit. Keep showing up.
Number one, follow a diet, no cheat days, no cheat meals, no alcohol. Rule number two, 2 45-minute workouts every single day. One of them has to be outside. Rule number three, drink a gallon of water a day. Number four, read 10 pages in an entrepreneurial nonfiction book. Number five, take a progress picture every single day of the challenge. The hardest part is if you mess up, you start again from day one. So this is 75 days in a row, no mess ups, no cheating, strictly testing your mental toughness. And I decided late last night that I was going to do it. So follow me along on my journey.
It is day three. I did yoga this morning and my back is sore in a good way. My back is sore, my arms are sore, my core is sore. And hold on, I'm sorry, there's like someone else, not someone else talking. I'm watching a video, but I was like, oh my gosh, I have to note this because this is some progress. I did the Chloe Ting arm challenge, and it was 10 minutes of arms, and I'm telling you, I never once was sore. But I did some yoga this morning, and it's like my back is sore, my arms are sore, my, what do you call them, triceps, not my biceps, my triceps, my shoulders, my back, like my upper back, and my core. So that's good.
Get it. You need to shut down all negativity and frankly not give a shit what others say and think. You want to know what the 10 most dangerous words in the English language are? What will other people say? And what will other people think? You're the only person who needs to be okay with how you live your life. You could be hated by everyone, and if you're okay with your actions and behavior, you'll be content. At the same time, you could be loved and adored by every damn person on the planet. But if you're not okay with how you've lived your life, you'll go to bed with emptiness. The losers we discussed earlier, there'll never be a shortage of them.
I think sometimes you just have to be so sick of what's happening in your life, so sick of all the pain, so sick of the people that have hurt you, that you say no more. I'm not gonna shrink myself down anymore for a man. I'm not gonna shrink myself down to make someone else comfortable with me. I'm gonna use my voice. I'm gonna be as loud as I wanna be. I'm gonna be as powerful as I wanna be. I'm comfortable with you being uncomfortable with me. I don't care if you think I'm too much because I think I'm enough. I don't care if you think I'm too sensitive because I think I'm
It is day six, you guys. And I literally cannot believe that we only have one more day and I will have the first week down. It's so crazy to me that it's gone this fast. I also want to say, y'all, I am so tired. It is 3:30 on Saturday afternoon and I did yoga this morning. Me and the kids went for a walk this afternoon and ran some errands in between that, and I had to go upload a video and do some YouTube work, and I'm just like, I cannot think of anything else other than going to sleep and taking a nap. I have been sleeping every single night from 7.5 to 8.5 hours, and then on top of that, taking a nap. But yeah, everything is going great. I'm just really tired and it's like, am I sore? My hamstrings are definitely sore. I have a blister up underneath my foot, which actually wasn't bad today. I think it was the shoes I was wearing yesterday on my walk, but my stomach hurts from the bloat. But other than that, like, it's good. I feel good. I'm just really, really tired. Hey guys, so it is Sunday, day 7. It is 10:59 and I'm about to go do my workout outside. I was sitting here just eating breakfast, just thinking about the things that I want to do today versus the things that I have to do today versus the thing that I kept telling myself I had to do today, like self-tan and exfoliate and put on a mask and like do all this stuff that I just literally don't have the energy for. And I'm not trying to complain here. I'm just trying to be real. It is going to take every ounce of every fiber of my being to get in this second workout outside. And I'm exhausted. I was sitting there eating breakfast and I was just like, oh my gosh, I just want to go lay in bed. And this is a definite mental toughness challenge because my mind is telling me, you can't do this. Now my mind and my body is telling me, you can't do this. I have been an emotional wreck. I have been an emotional wreck, honestly, all week. This has definitely been a challenge. I've been incredibly irritable. I have been just not pleasant to be around. So hopefully this all kind of, it's just my body adjusting and it'll adjust soon. And then we can move on with happy, peaceful Jill that's not so irritable. So week 1 is down and here are my thoughts. Week 1 was definitely a struggle. I was very tired pretty much all the time. I had to take naps pretty much every day. I was really moody. I was really moody, really irritable. I don't know if it was PMS related. Now, I've told you guys that I've had a hysterectomy. However, they left my ovaries, which means that I literally was about to like break down crying in my doctor's office when he told me that I would still deal with PMS symptoms. So I don't know if it was that. I don't know if it was the increase in activity. There's a lot of different things that was going on. So I don't know if it was PMS symptoms or if it was just related to the increase in activity. It was just a lot. Also, I changed the time in which I was waking up. So I was waking up every morning at 6. So there was just a lot of factors. But I want to say that I am loving this challenge. It did not feel like a week. Like when I did the 10,000 step per day challenge, I was just like, oh my gosh, is this thing ever going to end? But it was crazy to me to see how fast a week went by with this challenge. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to these next 68 days to see what they have in store for me. I literally have no desire to get on the scale. And that's going to upset people, but it is what it is. Please don't be upset about the choice that I make that I feel is best for my weight loss journey. The reason why I feel like it's best is because as I went through this week, I did not get on the scale once, which is big for me because I'm gonna be honest, I am a daily weigher. And when it came time for weigh-in day, the day before, and I knew it was like, okay, tomorrow's weigh-in day, what do you wanna do? And I was like, I have no desire to get on that scale. I don't care what it says. I don't want to know. I'm really trying to focus on what I love about this challenge so much is number one, it forces you to get outside and get some vitamin D and just breathe the fresh air. And it has been really amazing for me. I also love reading 10 pages of nonfiction. Someone asked why do this challenge? Like, you know, it's stupid, basically it's stupid, it's trendy, blah, 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 whatever else. The thing is that on a normal day-to-day basis, yes, I want to read more. But do I take the time to do it if I'm not challenged to do it? And that's on me. I get that. That's on me, but that's why people love challenges so much. We need to challenge ourselves because if we're not challenging ourselves, we are not growing. So whether you choose to do a 75 hard or you choose to do a challenge that you make up yourself, challenge yourself. Make sure you're challenging your mind and body and soul. You know, make sure you're challenging it all. It's all very important and all of it intertwines with one another. If you're not feeling good, you're not going to care to look good. If you're not looking good, you're not going to care to stay on this lifestyle and continue to lose weight. It's just, that's not everyone. That's me though, for sure. So my mental health has to be good. And reading 10 pages of nonfiction has just been so beneficial to me. And it's one of those things where I was sitting there today and I was like, would I actually take the time? No, I wouldn't if I weren't doing this challenge. So it is what it is. It's all about building little habits. And in the process of 75 days, I'm sure that I will have it down pat to where I'm like, I'm going to take 10 minutes out of every day or however long it takes me, however long of a time frame I set, I won't specify 10 pages. Maybe I will, maybe I won't, maybe I'll specify a time limit. But the thing about it is the fact that you're setting that time aside for yourself. All of this is all about self-care and self-love, and it's all so important, which goes back to the scale in the fact that I don't care to see what it says. A lot of you are also saying take measurements, and I will not do that. I've done it before and it just doesn't work for me. I like to go by my clothes and I also like to go by progress pictures because again, it's just another set of numbers for me to become obsessed over, and I'm over it. I'm feeling so good about bettering myself, and that's what this is about. It's not about the number on the scale because the number on the scale does not define my worth. If I lost 6 pounds this week, good for me. But what is the real important thing? The fact that I stuck to doing something really hard, and also the fact that I'm improving myself, the fact that I'm bettering myself, the fact that I am doing something good for myself and my soul and my heart and my mental health and my physical body, that is what's important to me at this moment. Now, will I do a weigh-in next week? I don't know. I'm just going to base it on how I feel. I'm definitely gonna be updating you guys week to week on how I'm doing on 75 Hard, and that's going to be uploaded on every single Wednesday. So if I do a weigh-in that Wednesday, I'll do it. If not, no big deal. And I hope that you guys can respect that. I know that a lot of people just think that it's like so taboo for you to not want to weigh yourself. And for me, it's like so peaceful to have finally gotten to this place Will this piece stay? I don't know. I hope so. But I don't need a scale to tell me what I weigh because there's so many factors that go into the whole scale situation as far as bloat, sodium, activity level, inflammation. Are you bloated? It's so much. Do you have to go to the bathroom? There's so much that plays into that number, and it's so negative for me. And literally, I kept going back and forth. Are you going to stay consistent if that number said, how would you feel if that number said you've lost 3 pounds this week? When you feel, because it was your first week back, that you should have lost 5 or 7, how would you feel if it said 3? And I was like, I'd feel like crap. And I'm like, all right, we're not doing it. I know what that scale does to me. I know the headspace that it puts me in. So with that being said, will I keep this up? I don't know as far as the no weigh-ins. I'm really about being positive, positive affirmations, positivity. I have been such a negative person my whole entire life that I'm really, really trying to work on not complaining, not playing the victim, not doing this self-pity crap that I always do. I'm really, truly focusing on working on the outside, the inside out, and it's all gonna come into play. And there's an affirmation that I say, and I'm gonna leave it with this, and that is, I say, and I think this is really important to say and really believe, because I will tell you this, I looked in the mirror the other day as I was tying my sneakers, and the first thing that I would have done previously is automatically went to the weight that I weigh in my head. You weigh 313 pounds. Ugh. Just disgusting. And do you know what I did? I'm so proud of myself. This is such growth. It's growth in such a short old time. I'm just so proud of myself. But I think that this all is like really coming together. And it is the fact that I told myself, I looked at myself and I was like, I am proud of you. I am proud of you for lacing up these sneakers right now, because you're about to go on a walk and you are bettering yourself. And that's the way you need to look at it. You don't necessarily need to just love the way your body looks every second of the day. Obviously, you don't love the way your body looks or feels, or there's lots of things that I could say about this. But I'm looking at myself and I'm not looking at myself in disgust anymore. And that is so important. So I tell myself, I love and accept myself wholeheartedly and unconditionally just as I am right now. I also tell myself, I am grateful for this loving, beautiful, healthy body that I have that continues to get stronger every day. I wanna leave you with this. You can do hard things. Whatever it is you wanna do with your life, and if you just put your mind to it and put the work in, it's going to happen for you. So yeah, I love you guys. I hope that you're having an amazing day, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.